Let's. And now the Q5. Today we'll do the oil and lube. And then I will work on another project after that I will show you. But first of all, crank the car up to have access underneath. Make sure you secured your car in a parking position. And then slide underneath. You have that plate underneath the car to remove. And the first thing you want to do is use a T25, a torque twist T25 right here. You have two of them to remove. You have also on two sides, two studs or plastic inserts. All I used is I pry that very gently with a screwdriver to pop that out. I need to go a little bit further. Once you get that slide out, get two, one on both sides, and be very gentle with it and pop that out completely. So you have a T25 on the other side, then you have the other one over there, and you have one in the center. I'll show a little enough friction to remove that one completely and then drain the oil. And while I'm at it, so I cleaned out the rim or the car this weekend, but that rim was super greasy, nasty, like you cannot imagine. And we can see the remaining inside because it was just like a brief cleaning. It's like super black. And what is happening, what I've seen, and that will be the next project. If you see right here, try to angle the lights differently. There we go. So the front CV axle, front driver CV axle, is completely cracked. You see right here, completely cracked and leaked the grease all over, the grease, and just coated everything, and that is not good. That is not good. So that's gonna be a pretty interesting project. So we'll see that on the next video. Okay, so I'm on the second plate underneath. Actually, you need to remove that completely. You have a couple that you can get with a flat screwdriver at the front. And then there will be two T25 all the way to the front of the plate. Here you have like, I think, eight of them. So you need to remove that completely to have access. Here we go. That plate is down. So just be careful when you drop that. If you're underneath the car, you see plenty of gravels. It will entrap like the first plate. So be careful if your face is underneath, you'll get some in your face. Okay, so now that you remove the two plates from the front side of the car, on that side, and you will see that one that will require a T45 to be removed. So just prepare your old pan. Right here, a lot better angle. So it will be a T45. Just, that one is pretty tight. There we go. So you unscrew that, prepare your Alpine and just drain it. Then I will lower the car to get it as flat as possible and drain as much as possible from it. Let's go. Okay, here is the old pan. Always put the angle of the pan at the beginning of the leak and be ready because it's going to squirt pretty far. And this will be warm, so be careful. I can grab it before it falls, and if not, it will be in a pan and I collect it after. And here we go. So let it drain. During that time, I'm going to clean the inside of the car, even if it doesn't take that long. And I'll show you the spec of the oil as well. Okay, I leveled the car. Also, what you want to do is remove that, we'll open that to the air, a little bit of drainage. And you can also pop out the hood just and snap it. There we go. Like that, you have access to the oil filter as well, if you're planning to replace it or not. Generally by hand, you can unscrew that, and if not, you use a filter wrench and just get it off. As far as the oil, what I'm using is synthetic 5W40, or you can use 0W40, but just double check and make sure it is compatible for Audi or the vehicle you're servicing. This is one, a special one for European vehicle, and it should require 4.5 quarts. Just double check your specification. But once it's drained, put the plug back in place, attach the plate, refill your oil, your filter, and you're good to go. And again, that was for an Audi. This is a 2015 2.0 V6 turbo. Pretty good car. Okay, car is flat, it's been draining for a while. I've been cleaning the car in between. I'll give it a quick wipe right here, just to make sure it's clean. It's still dripping, of course. Put the plug and make sure it's free of debris. You have the little ring, you're called to replace it or not. It's extremely cheap. Always tie them by hand first. Then after, you have the specification to follow. As far as the torque on it, just tighten that to the right torque, and then go and refill your oil, put the plate, and you're good. What I will do is refill the oil, let it sit for 30 minutes. I want to make sure I don't have any drip, make sure I got a proper seal, but there is no reason I won't. Okay, hopefully it helps. The rest is the same in reverse. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Thanks for your support, guys. Okay, be using a funnel. Pour the oil. Make sure you are aware of the volumes to put in. Double check your specification, and once you're full, then we'll double check inside the car. Run it hot. And make sure the level is okay, because it will measure that automatically. Okay, once you're inside, so make sure the oil is at temperature before you measure your oil level. Press on car. Then use a joystick. Get down to oil level. There's currently no information available about the oil level. That's interesting. That's because it's not at temperature. So we'll wait on that to be completely at temperature and do that again. Anyway, when you do a video, it's not only showing what to do, but what not to do as well, so you can shortcut certain things. Okay, just press on the start once without starting the car, but just the cluster. We need a few items, sir. Let's stop the radio. You're already on the car position, or if not, you press on the car button, go to oil level. For accurate measurement, the engine must be at operating temperature. It is, and I can see I'm slightly below the max, so I will top it up and do that again. So I hope it helps. Just want to show you the two plugs of the first plate. So you have some T25 to remove, three of them on the first plate, and you have also those two plugs where you'll put that upper part, and then you'll be able to slide that out. So just wanted to show you what it looks like, so it's a lot easier when you know what it is, how to remove them, then put them back in place, press them back in, and you're good to go.